Georgian special forces have taken hold of villages scattered throughout Azerbaijan. Incredibly, Kombayn Nikoladze appears to have been able to move thousands of troops across the border over a course of weeks, completely hidden from both local and international authorities through a high-tech... Number of Azerbaijani casualties are unknown, but early estimates number in the high...
The freedom-loving people of the world cannot stand idly by and allow an act of such staggering inhumanity and scale.
In their third day of fighting, U.S.-led NATO troops took three more Azerbaijani villages occupied by Georgian special forces. U.S. troops met only light resistance and suffered minimal casualties. The Georgian commando cells are becoming increasingly hard to locate as military intelligence suffers repeated... Kombayn Nikoladze has vanished, along with his top military advisors. Speculation points to Nikoladze's fear of a war crimes tribunal as motivation. A two-minute webcast from locations unknown, Georgian President Kombayn Nikoladze called America and its allies an army of scarecrows, declaring them helpless to defend themselves or their homeland. The precise nature of Nikoladze's threat, experts fear, could make itself known within...
GFO oil rig, Georgian waters, Caspian Sea. October 27th, 2004, 09:38 hours. Retrieve Georgian communication data. NATO and US intervention has pushed most of the Georgian commandos from Azerbaijan with only a few well-hidden cells remaining. One of those cells, entrenched in an oil rig on the Caspian Sea, is exchanging data with the presidential palace in Georgia via a secure network. Greetings, fellow Wilkins. Welcome back to some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell and First-Person Perspective. As the situation currently stands, it would seem that, the NATO has intervened in the war between Georgia and Azerbaijan, and as a result, Georgia is practically, you know, back on its heels defending itself right now. And one of the things that seems fishy thus far is the communication data from a certain oil rig, which Nikoladze seems to place a lot of interest in. You can actually tell because of how he's concentrating his troops in this specific oil rig. In case you guys didn't know, one of the things about Splinter Cell is that, or rather the Third Echelon, is that it's a SIGINT initiative, or in other words, signal interception initiative. They practically, how do I put this? They grab signal data from all around the world and basically monitor it all, communication, global communication, in order to find out, potential leads and threats against national security. So Sam is basically just an enforcer of their will in case, there's some or the other data which you can't, which isn't transmitted, or if they need some sort of proof for evil intents, or good intent, or maybe good intents, who knows. Sam's the guy who is sent in to fetch that data. At other times, he's also a network specialist who, takes the opportunity to move some pieces of the board, so to speak. So anyway, I have been dragging this out for quite a long time. Without further ado, let's do this.
Fisher, we've uploaded your mission objectives. Grim's daughter says the rig's encryption protocols are bulletproof, so we're going to have to let one of Nikoladze's geeks log on before we get a chance at any intelligence.
Why would they be holding onto this rig? It's not Nikoladze's smartest play.
That's what got our attention. Nikoladze is sacrificing several cells to hold onto it, so whatever's coming over the network must be critical. Mission objectives on your opsat.
So, one of the things that this lighting mod DG Voodoo 2 does is it makes the lights and shadows look spectacular. But as you can see here, I don't know why, but it's just with this mod, or maybe it's the PS2 enhanced textures, sorry, the PS3 enhanced textures, but the entire ocean looks blocky like that, like divided into separate grids and blocks. It is what it is, but in any way. One of the things that I was mentioning earlier was how, for the sake of clarity, this is also a post-gameplay commentary. I had voiced it over, but for whatever reason, the voiceover sucked, So, I mean, my recording equipment wasn't up to par, and I have just decided to voice it over again for the sake of preserving quality. Anyway, moving on, as we can see here, so basically Sam's job, as it has been all along, up until the new franchise, that is, from Conviction onwards at least, or even including Double Agent, is that he is a second ninja. And you will hear Lambert mention that in the next mission, the upcoming mission CIHQ as well, wherein his job is...
Visual on hostile forces. We're blowing the bridge immediately. Repeat, blowing the bridge.
Wherein his actual job is to practically... how do I put this? Yeah, intercept data, intercept signals, and he's a ninja that, you know, whose primary objective is to gather data. So, I mean, things take pretty drastic turn Double Agent onwards when he's actually going into a terrorist cell. Even though you might call it a part of signal interception, a more extreme form in either case, but but from Conviction onwards, it turns, the entire game turns into something of a... Something of a, you know, notion where Sam is like an Avenger in the sky,
bad news,
constantly protecting.
Something got the military's attention.
Oh boy.
Your rig just got bumped into the single digits on NATO's strike list. Find yourself a technician and get that data. Time just got scarce.
Constantly, like, just protecting the peace of the world, and while he used
Everybody
to do that anyway, the problem
our
is...
Technician. Is returning with the encryption key. I need two men to meet him at the docking station.
Yeah, I sort of skipped that dialogue there. I mean, I didn't mean to, but I guess I was just walking a little too quickly over there. Anyway, moving on. So yeah, I mean, that isn't problematic in itself. Sam used to do that before as well, but only when the opportunity arose. How it feels right now is that, with, you know, Conviction Blacklist, is that Sam has taken the security of not only his own nation, but the entire world solely on his shoulders. You know, like, he's this sort of a superhero who's only human, like sort of Batman. And I mean, it's got a completely different vibe, but it just deviates from the Tom Clancy, Tom Clancy methodology, or the spirit of Tom Clancy, just a little. So anyway, exposed wires on an oil rig. I wonder if that causes a short circuit. So yeah, as far as this mission goes, I do believe this is a good opportunity. I do believe it is a good opportunity to essentially showcase the power of the first-person mod and how it, you know, essentially turns the game into a tactical shooter. Or at least I thought so initially, but it wasn't until I played this mission that I found out that this mission in itself is quite inadequate. I'm just waiting for the other person down there to, you know, come back around so that I can jump on him. I don't have to, like, waste a bullet that way. I'm pretty sure a fall from this height onto somebody's neck would kill them. But anyway, here we are. So yeah, this mission just does not have a sufficient number of encounters for this mod to be enjoyable. Like, on its own, I mean. This mod will probably be quite enjoyable in the upcoming missions of Kalina Tech and Abattoir, but yeah. Aside from
That's
those missions, and maybe
airport.
Even towards the end of the Georgian Presidential Palace.
We'll keep you updated.
Yeah, maybe probably even near the end of Georgian Presidential Palace and the other missions, you know, around that, like after that, the extra missions, I mean. Anyway, so yeah, what was I saying before this? I forgot.
American fighter planes! They're coming in again! Reports of incoming troop transport!
As you can see, I mean, sneaking isn't really that difficult in this game. I mean, In third-person perspective, it feels pretty difficult, but now that, you know, I'm playing in the first-person perspective, I'm playing it more aggressively. I'm not so worried about, like, sneaking, per se. I honestly feel like sneaking is, like, a pretty easy thing in this game. And, yeah, like I said, I would rather want to get into encounters and, you know, just kill some people instead of sneaking past them. I'm just waiting for this guy. That was in the nick of time, and you can actually go inside and follow them, but yeah, that doesn't always end well. So, I mean, for this part at least, we need to maintain secrecy until, you know, he manages to get inside this room that we're above right now. Or rather, outside and above. But anyway, yeah. Like, this was one of the problems with this game, is that, you know, I had to turn around, because without turning about, I could not manage to get my legs up onto the, you know, the pipe. And the thing is, since you can't see your character, you don't know what the problem is.
Change of plan, you're going after that technician, Pyotr. You want a briefcase that's changed.
Downloaded the data to that.
The laptop is ignited. Use whatever form.
Say so. So yeah, I mean, the rest was pretty straightforward. I could have gone around and, like, fought the other enemies, you know, tried for gunfights, but it honestly seems sort of excessive. I mean, even this guy was out of my way. I just killed him for the sake of killing him. I didn't need to be honest. And you can see how much I suck at actually shooting, but, well, it is what it is. I'm hoping that in the other missions, this clean attack, I'll be able to pull this off much more effectively. In any case. So, I actually had to do this sequence a few times around. And yeah, as I think I was telling you guys about this in one of the previous, you know, videos as well, as to how it's difficult to tell what you're interacting with, primarily because of, you know, how you need to just get super close to it until your face is practically inside whatever it is that you want to interact with. So yeah, I mean, it gets a little difficult. Like, for example, I accidentally picked up the body there, and even though there was no call to actually do it, I didn't have to, you know, quick load over there. I just did anyway, because I didn't feel like wasting all that time. We could kill him right now, but I just wanted to have some fun and interrogate him for a change. And as I can see, it's also much easier to, you know, run circles around these people.
What makes this worth the risk?
Who the hell are you?
Don't ask any more questions. Answers only, and fast.
I understand.
Why risk manually extracting data from a battle zone?
It was the only way. We encrypted with a non-transferable destroy-on-use hard key.
What's the data?
I'm just a messenger. I don't know. Something about an Ark.
What's that?
I don't know. What Nikoladze wants most.
Where were you going to take the briefcase?
I don't know. I wasn't going to find out until I was on board the escape ship. Mass is a complete control freak.
Mass.
Please, I don't want to. Philip, Mass.
Yeah, I sort of accidentally skipped
that
message there. Too bad you can't do it again. Anyway, we got what we came for, and time to get out of here. I don't know why I picked up this actually, even though I'm not gonna read it.
Time to make yourself scarce.
And that's that for this mission. Let's head over to a briefing now. The debriefing, rather. GFO oil rig, Georgian waters, Caspian Sea, October 27th, 2004, 10:21 hours. Communication data received from the oil rig has proved to be invaluable. The records are full of vague hints concerning an impending retaliation against the US. More concretely, they show evidence of a leak in the US intelligence community, suggesting that the Georgians may have a mole inside one of America's agencies. Well, that is what we plan to, you know, investigate in the next episode. And if you have noticed, Philippe Mars has been a very rather prominent figure in the past two videos, including this one, I mean. So, yeah, as the story progresses, we'll realize the bigger picture of the role that Mars plays in all of this, including including the next video, that the upcoming mission, CIA headquarters. Anyway, that's for the next video, and until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.